On viewing it, I found it to be very disturbing, and at that part, I knew exactly what I was seeing and what course of action needed to be taken.
Differences between images recorded on police body-worn camera video and what's written in a police incident report led to the suspension without pay for 49-year-old Sergeant Ethan Newberg. The 24-year police veteran is charged with assault, false imprisonment, and misconduct in office.
This type of behavior simply cannot and will not be tolerated under any circumstances.
The police report dated May 30th claims Sergeant Newberg and Officer Alex Young were on routine patrol on Ashton Street in Southwest Baltimore. They were checking on a possible warrant for a man when another man began challenging them and caused a crowd to start to form, creating a hostile environment for the officers. The man was advised to stay away and he continued to interfere. But police say the video,
it shows the man speaking to Sergeant Newberg and walking calmly away after offering his opinion that Sergeant Newberg should have not placed the suspect on a wet sidewalk.
The video then shows Newberg chasing the man and grabbing him while the other officer puts the man in handcuffs. That man complained he was injured and was taken to St. Agnes Hospital, where the two officers claim a clear bag containing a white rock substance, suspected cocaine, was recovered. Police say all of this is under investigation. Baltimore's mayor supports the commissioner's decision.
The commissioner was appropriate in taking swift action to do what he did so we can restore trust in the police department. The officer will have his day in court. No one has said he's guilty of anything, but what I saw on the video, I was very disturbed by.
Now, according also to the court charging document, another officer told Sergeant Newberg to relax. Newberg's response, never question the way he does things, ordered the officer to leave the scene, and later called that officer, who is Hispanic, a kumbaya officer. Reporting live from Southwest Baltimore, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV 11 News.